basement, played rock and roll. They were the last of a dying breed. Damn the torpedoes ties, they could really let it be. They weren't afraid of anything or anybody, like skinny little dogs in a cage. They get drunker than you've ever gotten in your entire life. Have another drink on top of that one and walk right out onto the stage. I first went to see him, 'cause Jeff Sweeney said I should. Cantrell's in January, they weren't any good. The lead guitarist was naked, they'd all had too much beer. They had marshals turned up to 10, which ordinarily wouldn't be such a bad thing, but they were trying to tune up by ear. So I gave him another chance at the shed, opening for Petty. What could go wrong? Well, this time they were wearing dresses, drinking whiskey, and never finished a song. So now I'm angry, 'cause money don't grow on trees. Standing out in the parking lot with tickets for the next night already in my hands, thinking to myself, geez, what am I gonna do with these? So I went, largely to say I was there. Drove home white knuckles, straight jacket, dumbass blind. They were the greatest rock and roll band I ever did hear. Had to look twice to make sure it was the same guys. An astonishing transformation, from pupa to butterfly, Saul to Paul, cougar to Mellencamp. Like crawling inside of exile on Main Street and pulling never mind the bullocks up to your chin like a sonic quilt. They were nice guys, and they were dicks. You wouldn't know what they'd do. One show might run 25 songs and alter your perspective, and the next might fall apart before it got to number two. But folks come out to see them, if only to say they saw them before they were dead. And others to see if they could be anywhere near as good or as bad as everybody else said. They snorted lines and lost their minds and notched their guns all over the sphere. Got to where they couldn't tell you what day it was, what month it was. They couldn't even zone in on a year. They puked in their hands and tossed it on the ceilings of dressing rooms on tour. And college rock and roll journalists wrote it all down. Truth, lies, they weren't sure. They burned every bridge, they didn't blow sky high, then started pissing off each other too. It was brother against brother then, and not enough drugs to do. cause it couldn't do much else. That way of life is a flaming star that grows real big and red and giant, and then it falls in on top of itself. Chris, he's a painter now, solo artist. Slim Dunlop is the proof of the existence of God, a guitar genius, a role model, a credit to the gene pool. Tommy moved to California to work for Axl Rose. I think he should team up with Slash and form Slash and Pop. They'd rock the house, they'd sell tickets, it'd be the most. Paul is in the basement, writing ballads, drinking Odoo. Bob is up in heaven, shooting speed, smoking coolers. The Replacements played rock and roll. They were the last of a dying breed. Damn the Torpedoes types. They could make you holler, make you sweat. They knew only women bleed. They were Charles Bukowski with Watts and Vomit. You paid and you took your chance. Cause when they were good, when they were good, when they were good, God got up to dance. You ever seen God dance? He'll show you a step or two.